Mrs. Marlerson.
Oh, call her back then.
Now then, Davidson. We are going to get to you.
Good morning. Mr. Marler for you.
Yes, I do realize that I woke you up. Yes, I know you're not a cleft stick for leaving messages. Look, come to the point, darling. What was the message?
Poor old sod. Did it sound... All right. All right. Thank you, darling.
You can't.
Sorry, my father's in a bad way.
You mean you're not going to be at the meeting?
It is my father, sir.
Yes, of course, forgive me. Sorry to hear about it, Michael.
Thank you, sir.
Look, couldn't you just finish that report for me? It'll only take half an hour.
Well, I haven't seen him for 5 years. I don't imagine half an hour longer will worry him. A decision taken by that committee. Our American counterparts, who switched to computers at the time, have already taken control of the British market and branded our adding machines as the poor man's computer. So much for Britain's businessmen. All right, love. 3 copies, 1 to Hazlitt by 2:30. Ring my wife, tell her I've gone to Liverpool.
Come home.
And not before time, neither.
Hello there, Kath. You haven't changed a bit.
Come.
How is he?
Oh, not too good, Mick. He'll not belong with us.
Don't be ridiculous, Ma. There's many a man had heart attack before now and gone on for donkey's years. Well, there's a kettle. You'll take some tea, Mick.
Thanks. How's her, Philip?
God, that one. Gives me a pain. Not heard much from you, Michael. Is everything going well with you down there?
Oh, fine, fine. Shall I go up and see him?
Well, he's sleeping just now, but ask him would he like some tea.
To the depths of I cried unto thee, O Lord. O Lord, hear my voice. Let thine ears be attentive to the voice of my supplication. I can't remember anymore. Sorry. Ah. Somebody put the boot in. Didn't they, old fella? He won't be needing his tea, Ma. I'll go for the doctor.